Frank said you wanted me with you.
Yes, I thought it might be nice to have a bit of girl time together. You know, get to know each other. So how did you guys meet?
We started talking on the phone. I guess I liked that it wasn't real.
What I like about you and Bruce Willis in this film is that, like, here's two grown-up actors amongst many grown-up actors, but you guys seem to have that whole teenage crush thing going on.
Yeah.
Is Bruce Willis easy to crush on?
Yeah. I mean, and there is something so innocent about the relationship in a way, you know, sort of like that, like, 30s, like Preston Sturges type banter. And it's, I think it's kind of refreshing. It's not like some crazy, like, overly sexual. Well, they're still attracted to each other, but it's not, it's lighter than that, sweeter.
Yeah. There's a lot of explosions, a lot of guns, a lot of, like, big-name actors, and yourself included. Does this make you want to kind of keep doing films of this scale? Do you think your next project, maybe you're going to look at a scale like this, or do you think you want to take a break?
I would love to do a movie like this if it had those kind of actors in it, you know, and if I felt like, you know, I could do it well,
yeah.
If they offered it to me. They don't usually offer me this kind of movie, but...
There were a lot of great people to work with on this film. For your next project, if you had to grab one of them and take them with you, who would you take?
They're all so great in different ways, and actually, and Bruce is so wonderful, you know. Whenever the director would say Bruce and Mary Louise, it was so, because my brother's name is Bruce, so I felt like it was like my mother talking to hear Bruce and Mary Louise. So bizarre. But John is, you know, he's what I always wanted to be, and he's like, that's kind of what I aspire to as an actor.
What struck me when I spoke to you guys on the set in New Orleans is how mellow and how chilled out he is in real life, and he's a lunatic in this film. Did you feel like this character for you was a stretch?
Yeah, I mean, I think she has that naivete and that sort of sweetness, that like effusive, naive quality. And I mean, she's awkward, and I think that I certainly feel awkward, but in a different way. But I think she's just so positive and such a romantic, and that's so fun to play.
And obviously you've got Weeds rolling right now, and you've got, I'm curious kind of where does this fit in your larger career arc right now? What's your next project, and what can we look forward to you in?
You can look forward to seeing me take my children to school. That's really all I'm doing. That's how I wanted to spend the fall. And if something comes along that feels, you know, good and it's just a little period of time, I would do it. But for now, it's like it's Halloween, it's going to be Thanksgiving, and it's fall, and it's just they're in their little sweaters and coats. And so that's my project right now. Red.